Honorable Member from Tyne Valley-Sherbrooke and the opposition whip.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Last week, a group of leading economists, doctors, and health experts from across the country published a letter calling on provinces to implement more robust paid sick leave programs that include at least 10 paid sick days for workers. This would align with countries like New Zealand and Australia, where workers have a right to 10 employer-paid sick days, and would still fall short of the stronger protections in countries like Sweden, which is 14 days, and Germany, which is 30 days. These experts argue that even beyond the pandemic, quote, "We are all better off when people don't go to work sick. At a societal level, this means less illness and death, lower healthcare costs, and higher economic productivity," end quote. Our lowest paid, most precarious workers are the most likely to not have paid sick days. Women and racialized workers are overrepresented in this group. Women are consistently more likely than men to need to take time off from work due to illness or disability, childcare, and elder care responsibilities. Too many workers have to choose between going to work sick and paying their rent. For too many workers, staying home to take care of a sick child can mean not being able to pay the electric bill or put food on the table. When I asked about permanent paid sick leave last week in this House, the minister told us this government will start looking at the idea of paid sick days after the pandemic. How can we have a successful economic recovery without considering the well-being of workers and their families? Again and again, workers have and continue to be an afterthought. If we want a fair and just recovery for all, business as usual simply isn't going to cut it. First and foremost, PEI workers must be respected and valued, not just as the backbone of island businesses, but as people who build and contribute to our communities. How can we make PEI workplaces the best, safest, and most equitable for all our island workers in our economic recovery should be the first question we ask ourselves as we plan to move beyond this pandemic, not the last. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.